Well, I must, oh my goodness, I must say how special that was for me, Norwood. And I just want to say good morning and to our outstanding mayor, Garcetti, and all the city council members of the great city of Los Angeles. And good morning also to my family, friends, and fans. Councilmember Kern D. Price, District 9, Council President Herb J. Wesson, District 10, and Councilmember Marquis Harris Dawson, District 8. I am honored and humbled today, as you have recognized me for my work in the entertainment business as a member of the Miracles. We started our career 16 years ago, even though I probably was not quite born, but I was at the time, we didn't have a clue that we would be signed to the label and make our living as singers for this many years. Smokey and I became a part of the group along with, Smokey already was a part of the group The Matadors, and he had my brother Emerson Rogers, my cousin Bobby Rogers, Pete Moore, and Ronnie White. They were the five guys that sang with the Matadors. I had a sister group called the Matadorettes. My brother decided that nothing was happening with the industry of music, so he decided that he would go and join the United States Army. And that he did, and about a month later, an audition came about, and that's how we ended up meeting Mr. Gordy and the guys, Smokey first, asking me if I would go on the audition with him. I went on the audition, as you've heard, in my United States Marine Corps Reserve uniform. That was a great experience for me because being a part of the Marine Corps, I became a sharpshooter. And it was a pleasure for me to be a part and to do a little in serving our country. I actually wanted to become a real Marine and go in the field, but my mother wouldn't sign for me because I was too young to sign for myself, so that's how I was on the reserves. So after the audition, Mr. Gordy actually was there. He wasn't the one we were to see, but he liked what he heard from us. The other people, unfortunately, didn't like us at all because they said the world did not need a group with a girl in the background, because what he was speaking about was a group that was the Platters, who were very famous at that time. And Mr. Gordy took a real interest in us and said that what he'd like to do is work with us. At the time, he was a songwriter. He had not formed the Tamla Motown record label yet. And he started working with us, and that was 1957. And our first record was released in 1958. And with that, we were not on Motown, we were on a record label called the N Record Label. And I won't tell you all the history of that because I'm going to be gone here for a long time. And Mr. Gordy, after receiving our first royalty check, which was the total amount of $3.19, and that actually was to be divided among all five of us. So Smokey suggested that maybe Mr. Gordy should start his own record company, which he had already had a desire to do anyway. But he started the company, and the company started January 12th, 1959. And from that time, when we did make a recording of Shop Around, it became Motown's first million seller. And with that Shop Around becoming a million seller, it sort of put Motown on the map and the Miracles, and we were able then to travel around the world and meet many, many wonderful people. And I just want to thank each and every one of you for continuing to carry on the legacy, or help me carry on the legacy of the Miracles. Two of our members, unfortunately, are deceased, Bobby Rogers and Ronnie White. And I miss them terribly. Thank you. the PAL Awards, which is Heroes and Legends, excuse me. I didn't realize I was going to become emotional. And it was the PAL Awards they give with Jane Bradford, the founder, gives out scholarship awards each and every year, and this actually is her 28th year, which will be in the Beverly Hills Hotel in September. And I can't thank enough for my children, which are actually my miracle children, Mary and Emma, who give me life and the desire to just continue on each and every day. And with that, they gave me three grandchildren, Lyric, Thomas, and Alexis. And my heart just beams proudly when I think of them. And I just get glad all over again. So, and I also want to thank Cynthia Busby of Busby Promotions for her work and recommending me for this honor of the city council. I also want to thank my accountant, Rick Norris, who's celebrating his 38 years. this is his 38th year, actually, and his anniversary today, so I didn't think that he'd be able to be with us, but he is, and I'm proud to say that I'm happy he is. Keeps me functioning financially. And also, Detective Rachel Shannon, who is here today, who's been my friend for over 20 years, and so proud that she made another grade, because she was Officer Shannon to us for so many years, but she's here today along with her daughter. And I'm just proud to have everybody here, and I want to thank each and every one of you who are here today, and I'm honored, I'm humbled, and feel extremely blessed to be here. And I thank you for this honor.